that when you leave, right? And I saw she was a baby over your old place over there in Delta, remember?
Yeah.
Crazy, man.
Don't slow it down when you pass the legs. The knees. Speed up. Good.
Okay, guy, we'll see you around,
okay? Oh, I'll park back there. So there's no space. All these guys here just have to take up their spots.
So you want to stay?
Yes.
You want to get checked in, right?
Yeah, yeah.
No, I moved it already.
Really extend the body. Pull the body up. Pull yourself under the bar. Finish quicker with the arms. Okay, really get it into place right away. Better, yeah.
See you guys.
Right there, trying to bring the bar for
almost. Yes, I'm assuming he'll be there.
Oh, yeah. Matt will probably lift him. He's gonna lift. We've got a few people that will probably lift.
Yeah. Okay. I told you.
Yeah.
Okay, buddy, thank you. Yeah. See you, guy.
Okay, see ya.
Hey, Brock, you coming? Where is he? Brock!
Okay, so for these two full things.
Is it a good fold? Is it all sorts of stuff?
Remember those quick arms, pulling yourself on your strong
side.
Taking
pictures, texting me.
Faster. Pull yourself right under. Hips down. Better. Go a little bit stronger with arms, right? Just a little bit stronger. A little faster. If you
thank you.
one rep.
Nice strong start, get that bar moving.
Strong and fast, get that bar moving. Yeah, good. Strong and fast. That bar moving all the way. Yep. Stay. Good. Yep, stay with it. Too bad. Almost looked like, I don't know, like on this side, yeah, it didn't lock out.
I'm not sure what it was.
Because you could see on the other side it kind of went, like you kind of pushed out, and on this side went this way.
Yeah.
Right? So, just when you're in the bottom, try not to bounce the hips around. Okay, try to get down there and
stay.
And stay down. Really squeeze that bar and maintain that position. When you're bouncing the hips a little bit, then it's hard to really control that weight here. Yeah. Because I thought the pull was pretty good.
Okay.
Not bad, but he didn't really move under it well. So he stopped moving. Right? It was almost like you pulled hard, kind of stopped, and then you're trying to drop. Okay. You have to put yourself forward down. We'll just do one more time with this. Down. Yep.
you pulled it pretty good. And then right at the bottom, you know, I don't know if you guys can see it, but as you got to the bottom here, it was like you're fighting against it instead of letting it relaxing, kind of relaxing the hips a little bit, letting that weight hold you down, getting control of it, and then stand up. And then right away when you did that, you could see also that shift over to that side.
Yeah.
This side came up and that side was coming down.
The feet went back about 2 inches.
Yeah.
That also often puts you up front as well too, right? Staying on top of the pole, you won't do it.
Yeah, you have to
jump back. Pop back, yeah.
What we're saying is that the power snaps, when I watched the video, not something that can't be, you know, worked out. So for with this weight here, I want you to do one from the floor and one from the hang above the knees. Okay? So I want to see some speed and aggressiveness. Keep those elbows out. I told him never to do another thing there. I mean, he said he wanted a coaching course there, same thing, nobody was signing up. Everywhere else people signed up. Want to get that bar moving. Keep it in against the body. Still a little bit getting away from you here, and the elbow's going this way.
Yeah.
The elbows, the bar into the body.
Yeah.
Okay, so as you pass it, you know, you want to start with the bar in.
Yeah.
Once you get better at it, then of course you can increase the speed slightly. Good. Same thing now. Get that bar moving, push and pull. A little bit better. You can see you know how imagine how when we got to the heavy weights and the left side is higher than the right side.
Yeah.
You can see that in your pull with that in that way.
Is that right?
Yeah. And you're not pulling at the same level on your left side.
So the bar is going a little bit more similar.
It's not a big difference, but as the weight gets heavier, then it might be even more.
Mm-hmm.
So just really focus on that harder with it.
Okay, yeah.
The jerks are good, feeling good.
It felt better than the last session. Yeah. Before that, my dip was always. I think it's a lot in here too.
Yeah, if you're trying to, you shouldn't have to try to feel where you're going. It should be, you know, kind of automatic.
Yeah.
And maybe you're just dipping a little bit too much.
Yeah.
You're gonna kind of feel the bar, you know, as you dip and as you drive, you mm-hmm. feel it.
Lately, I've been trying to sort of push, but just activate the arms a little bit in the dip.
Yeah.
And that has felt better, more involved, right. So speaking.
Yeah, as long as you're not like dipping and dropping.
Yeah.
For a strike. Shows me that you can.
Good?
Yeah. Same idea, one to be one from the floor, one from the hang. Just shrug, no arms, shoulders.
Nope.
So first one from the floor, your arms are broke.
Yeah.
Okay. So when your arms break like you're not being tracked and it's hard to run. step. When you get into this, you're ready to go.
Okay, yeah. Yeah.
If the speed is a little bit up, it's kind of like pulling you at the bottom and now you're trying to pull up.
Out of control.
Yeah. So your first, both from the hand, you're a little too fast, lower than down.
Okay.
And on the one below the knees, you went too low.
Yeah.
Okay. It's just below the knee.
Yeah.
Okay. So you should feel that bar here. Because of your wrist and all that, let's just make it a couple of reps. We just want to get you more comfortable with the movement.
Thank you.
Too much if you're efficient.
Yeah,
if you're moving well.
Yeah.